Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. Landslide in Bingyol. Presidents of Armenia and Artsakh participated at the unveiling of the monument dedicated to Maghavouz village residents who fell in Artsakh War. In Aleppo took place the reconsecrate ceremony of the local Armenian church. Aznavour's announced sites France to honor the great singer's legacy by launching exhibition. CNN travel include Armenia among the world's 23 best hiking trails. Tourist flow to Portasar will increase. Because of the heavy rainfall in the Solon district of Bingyol, has been registered an incident of landslide which has blocked the road leading to the Inandik village. For some time, the traffic and the residents were in a desperate state. It was possible to restore traffic and pedestrian crossing only after special cleaning with special equipment. President Armen Sarkisian, who is in Artsakh on a two-day working visit together with the president of Artsakh, Bako Sahakian, participated at the unveiling of the monument dedicated to the 70 residents of Maghavouz village in Martaket region who gave their lives in the Artsakh War. President Armen Sarkisian and Bako Sahakian laid a wreath at the monument and paid tribute to the memory of the residents of Maghavouz killed in the Artsakh and Great Patriotic Wars. For courage demonstrated during the April 2016 war, President Bako Sahakian awarded the group of Maghavouz residents with Artsakh state honors. Afterwards, the presidents of the two Armenian states had a conversation with the residents of the village present at the event. Catholicos of the Great House of Cilicia of the Armenian Apostolic Church, Adam I, has reconsecrated the 40-matris Armenian cathedral in Aleppo, Syria. As reported earlier, Aram I has arrived in Aleppo to perform this reconsecration ceremony. Built in the 15th century, the 40-matris Armenian Cathedral is considered the oldest church in the Armenian community of Aleppo. Restoration process of this church, which was considerably damaged during the years of the Syrian conflict, was launched in the May of 2018. The restoration of the church was made due to the contributions of the members of the Armenian community in Aleppo. At least 150,000 believers have contributed to the restoration of the church. The first ever Charles Aznavour exhibition is going to open in France to feature many undisclosed sides of the great singer's life and creative career. La Bazin Castle will host the cultural event entitled Aznavour's Unknown Sides to showcase the legendary singer's photo archives and personal items. Aznavour once visited the Jean-Paul Belmondo exhibition in Paris, where he joked saying, "Why don't they dedicate an exhibition to me?" A curator of the museum said, adding that they initiated the preparations of the big event while Aznavour was still alive, receiving the singer's approval. CNN Travel has compiled a list of 23 best hiking trails in the world. Easily overlooked, Armenia has some of the best walking trails in Europe, the search reports. The 12-day Armenia and the Silk Road trip takes in some of its finest routes, connecting the UNESCO-protected monasteries of Sanahin and Hakbat, passing over limestone peaks and through verdant forests with the opportunity to hike in the wild Gerama Mountains and climb to the top of Aragats, the country's tallest mountain. The source describes the Armenia country's hiking trails. It was decided to increase the number of buses to Portasar, which is included in the UNESCO World Heritage List. The visitors are mostly attracted to the T-shaped stones with wild animals imprints and the remains of the Cathedral of Portasar. From now on, the number of buses going to Portasar will increase. This will allow tourists to get acquainted with the historic building, which has not yet been fully discovered. Now let us represent to your attention a song by Gagik Sarkisian.
Thank you.
You can find the whole version of the song in the official page of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.